Now, Tenney wore his uniform with pride and served his country with honor.
But a Wisconsin Marine says when he turned to the Veterans Hospital for help, he was sexually abused by a male caregiver. Colleen Henry has our 12 News investigation.
The 29-year-old Marine first went to police a year and a half ago. The investigation recently wrapped up. Now, a word of warning, the description of the abuse he alleges is graphic. It also embarrasses him, so he's asked us not to show his face.
Michael is a Wisconsin Marine who served his country for 4 years, from Camp Lejeune, North Carolina, to tours in the Mediterranean.
My Marine Corps career is one of my most proud accomplishments in my lifetime.
Today's fighting another battle. He's speaking out to put a stop to a military medical provider he trusted.
No matter how hard it is to talk about it and how much of a slap in the face it is, in order for him to be stopped and not continue to do this to other people.
In August of 2007, Michael headed to the Milwaukee VA for treatment of a skin virus that left lesions on his genitals. He saw a nurse in the dermatology clinic.
He said that in order to see the lesions better, the skin had to be pulled tight. In order for the skin to be tight, he said it's easier if you're erect. He would make it so that you are. You know, it was two hands and it was some weird method that made it seem more medical.
Michael says when he left the clinic, he told his wife they agreed the treatment sounded strange but seemed to make sense, so he returned here for continued treatment. He says the touching escalated, that his suspicions were cemented when the nurse touched him with his bare hands.
That's weird to me. I mean, a doctor puts on a glove when they check your heartbeat.
Michael says he cried, and when he got home, he called a local dermatologist to describe the treatment.
This is way beyond the scope of normal medical practice, is what that doctor told me. He said, this is way wrong.
Michael immediately called Milwaukee police, who investigated. Prosecutors said there wasn't enough evidence at the time to press charges. So the VA started its own investigation. A year and a half later, the investigator told Michael he'd found about 50 other patients who'd claimed abuse by the same nurse.
It's an unusual and very difficult job to deal with.
Attorney Marty Kohler represents the nurse, whom we're not naming because he hasn't been charged with the crime. Kohler says the nurse denies any wrongdoing.
He has to touch the penis. If somebody reacts, people get embarrassed by that. Is there a potential tug or something that to get to the infection that he's treating? Yeah, that's the normal course of treatment.
So it was not fondling?
No.
As for the dozens of other alleged victims identified by the VA investigator,
I'm very suspect of anything that they have to say.
12 News has obtained a letter sent to VA patients inquiring about sexual abuse at the Milwaukee Dermatology Clinic. It includes questions like, did any staff member tell you your genitals needed to be erect to be treated? Did any staff member manipulate your genitals? Kohler says the letter is suggestive and taints the investigation.
So you think he's planting seeds?
Oh, yeah.
What they did was they went through the medical records and pulled out names.
Michael hired attorney Victor Harding to file a personal injury claim against the nurse and the VA. It's the first step in a lawsuit. Harding expects other patients to join them.
There may be other people who voiced complaints and sought help and either never got it or got swept under the table.
I like the VA, and that is why it's very hard to... It makes it harder to throw up a flag like this because it makes the VA look bad.
Michael says his shame at being duped diminished when he learned he may be one of many.
Are you telling me that 50 people, and who knows how many more, are that gullible that none of them are wise enough to say, what the heck are you doing? Stop. It would be better. It would honestly be better to have been forcefully taken advantage of. Way better. Because at least then I would have known what was going on and I would have had a chance to fight for myself.
Now, his lawyer says the nurse has treated thousands of patients at military hospitals across the country without complaint. The VA declined to answer questions because of the ongoing investigation. It says the nurse remains a VA employee, but the nurse's lawyer says he is no longer seeing patients. His nursing license, however, remains active here in Wisconsin, Toya.
All right, so there's no criminal charges in this original case, but the DA is now revisiting the case.
Right. The VA investigator took his findings regarding the 50 other patients to the DA. The DA tells 12 News a decision on criminal charges could come next month.
All right. Thank you, Colleen.